Can a $99 one-time product be better than selling a $9 a month recurring subscription? That's what I talk about on today's episode. Hello and welcome to episode number 61 of the Subscribe Me show from subscribeme.fm. where I talk about creating membership sites and online courses, how to make, market, and monetize digital content, the world of WordPress, and tools, techniques, and tips that you can use to create a long-term profitable online business. I'm Ravi Jagopal. I'm the creator of CoolCastPlayer.com, a pretty yet powerful audio player and podcast player plugin for your WordPress site. Sometimes we try to plan far too ahead. We plan for something so big, so wide and so deep that we get overwhelmed by the future scale and magnitude before we even get started. What am I talking about? We start worrying about how the heck am I going to lose 50 or 70 pounds before we lose a single pound, before we even get into the habit of going for, say, a 10-minute walk. We start planning about going to the gym every single day for the next year rather than just bite the bullet and go for one day today and then follow it up with another day tomorrow, and then follow that up for a full week, then do that for a month, and so on. You have to stack the results. A journey of 1,000 miles begins with a single step. That's a lousy quote. No, wait, I don't mean it's a terrible quote. I mean lousy as in the Chinese philosopher, L-A-O-Z-I, Lao-Zi. So it may be a lousy quote, but it's certainly not lousy. It's so true that a journey of 1,000 miles begins with a single step. And the journey of a successful subscription-based business starts with, you guessed it, an epic one-time product. In today's episode, I'm going to share a very stark and dark truth that when you're first getting started, selling a one-time product for $99 is better than selling a recurring subscription for $9 a month. You're probably like, wait, what? Ravi, but you're the guy who has a podcast about membership sites and recurring subscriptions. You talk about dog poo versus dosa. By the way, dog poo stands for do once, get paid only once, and dog poo stinks, right? And dosa, D-O-S-A-A, stands for do once, sell again and again. So dog poo stinks, dosa rocks. Now back to your voice. But Ravi, you're the guy who talked about dog poo versus dosa, and you're the guy who's always saying that you have to add a recurring subscription model if you want your business to flourish in the long term. So Ravi, you're now telling me that I'm better off with a one-time product rather than a recurring subscription? Well, the answer is yes and no. Of course, there are some clauses and disclaimers, and it only applies to specific conditions. So don't freak out just yet. You should plan big, but start small, which is why you should plan and prepare to add a subscription model in the future, but you should get started right now with a one-time product. So be sure to listen to the full episode to understand my perspective, where I also talk about two of the biggest membership site pricing mistakes that people make when it comes to charging subscription fees. And I'll give you an example from Hollywood. So let's take the recent Tom Cruise movie, The Mummy. Now, if you've watched the Brendan Fraser's version, which I grew up watching and I absolutely loved it, then you know that it was lighthearted. You know, it didn't take itself too seriously. There was a lot of great fun for the whole family. But with the new Tom Cruise version of The Mummy, Universal Studios focused way too much on what they've started calling the dark universe, which is supposedly a whole series of characters and movies planned well into the next few years. So basically, somebody at Universal looked at what Marvel's doing with their Marvel Cinematic Universe, or MCU. When they first released Iron Man, then it was Thor, and then came Captain America, and so on. Sorry if I got the order incorrect. And then came the Avengers, where all those characters came together, and on and on. So they looked at that, and then they looked at the DC Universe, and someone at Universal Studios must have been like, dude, look at what those guys are doing with their massive universes. We need to create a mega multi-billion dollar brand so we can also churn out character after character and movie after movie for the next few years. And in 5 years, we make one big movie where we bring all these characters together and that will take a life on its own and it'll get its own series like the Avengers or Justice League. Yeah, we all know how that turned out. The Mummy turned out to be one of the biggest busts of the year. They tried to plan too much for the future movies and tried to set, you know, plant all the seeds for a future mega franchise instead of focusing on creating one great movie right now. How about coming with one epic song first before you plan a platinum album? So it's always about the beginning. Start with one epic product. You know how people talk about USP? Right? They ask you, what's your USP? What's your unique selling proposition? Instead, think of it as UKP, unique killer product. So what is that one unbelievable, epic, killer, remarkable product that you can come out with, whether it's an online course or a community or a software product or a full-blown membership site, whatever it is, that will let you just go out there and crush it. So when you're first getting started, don't worry about the 50 pounds, losing all the 50 pounds together. Don't worry about making all of the $1 million together. Don't worry about charging a subscription fee right from day one. Yes, you should plan it and structure it and plan for this whole, where this whole thing is going to go eventually and what you're doing now and how it can eventually all become a part of a recurring subscription-based membership site one day, but you don't have to implement all of it today. There is a similar best practice in programming. The best software and system architects know how to do this stuff. And I've been one of the best, even if I say so myself, in my past life as a software architect and engineer. And that best practice is that you design the backend, the database and all those stuff, the whole structure of a system in such a way that it accommodates future growth and new features and scalability and all the good stuff, but you implement the code in small phases. You iterate. You go phase after phase. So iterate, small steps. On the one hand, as soon as you get an idea, you don't just sit down and start coding 5 minutes later, right? You still have to think things through. You still have to plan for scalability, security, flexibility, and so on. So my personal advice is think big, but start small and act fast. Now, before we dive in, I have a very special announcement to make. And I'll be making that full announcement at the end. And trust me, you will not want to miss it because it is all about you. And it's something that's totally skewed in your favor and completely puts me at a huge disadvantage. So keep listening.
Subscribeme.fm.
Membership site pricing mistake number one. Now, just because everybody, including me, is talking about how you should push towards subscription-based products doesn't mean that your first product or your first launch should be a subscription-based product or service. Sometimes it's just better to launch just one product that you sell for a one-time fee and build a list of customers and fans and, of course, future monthly subscribers. Sometimes it's just better to launch just one product that you sell for a one-time fee and build a list of customers and fans and, you know, also future monthly subscribers. It's a lot better to launch with a single one-time product rather than try to create this elaborate course with topics that people may or may not care about, and then forcibly slapping a recurring model on top of that, or a recurring subscription, just because everybody else is saying, oh, you have to sell recurring products. You have to sell recurring products and not one-time products. And then we end up wondering why it's not working. So you can actually use one-time products to quickly build an audience and see if they're interested in the topic to begin with, to test if you can actually reach an audience that's interested in your topic. And a one-time product lets you get to market really quickly without worrying about having to create this elaborate stack of value that you need in order to get somebody to subscribe and pay month after month. Remember, just because you got somebody to subscribe to your monthly $9 subscription doesn't mean you have a great subscription model. It just means that you have lowered the value of your one-time product and spread it out over, you know, 12 months, and they probably end up staying 3 months. I'll talk more about that in a little bit. This is exactly what we did in my own business at digitalaccesspass.com or DAP. Of course, I can't take all the credit for this. Most of the credit goes to my wife, Veena Prashant, who is my beautiful and brilliant wife and who's the co-founder and co-developer of DAP. And today we have a subscription tier where you can get DAP and all of our plugins that we develop outside of DAP like Coolcast Player and S3 Media Vault. And you get 2 hours of personalized concierge and coaching calls, ongoing premium monthly support for an up to an hour, and so on. But we didn't always have all those additional things to package. DAP was initially launched as a one-time product many years ago, 2008, October, to be specific. We were the first WordPress membership plugin, by the way. And we offered 3 different versions of the same one-time license, like one-time unlimited site and one with some concierge help, right? We called it membership site in a box. So those are the only 3 versions we had for many, many years, and we did very well. We had no problems. You know, we didn't have a subscription model, but we had, you know, a built-in thing into software that's, you know, renewal and upgrades and support. So there's a kind of, it's like an Apple iPhone. It's not a subscription, but you will eventually want to buy it, right? Some people buy it every year. Some people buy it once in 3 years. Same way with DAP, when we didn't have the forced renewal, right? We made it optional renewal. You could renew anytime you want. Or if you didn't want to renew, you didn't have to. So recurring subscriptions are not always the right solution. Not all products lend themselves well to a recurring subscription model. So you can't always take a one-time product and just spread it thin and drag it out and add fake value to it and call it a subscription product. For example, let's say you have a course about Facebook advertising. We'll assume it's a really good course, has great content, offers great value and training and tips and all the good stuff and techniques and how to get the best out of advertising on Facebook. Now, you may be tempted to sell it as a subscription, but the fact that this is just this one course alone is not enough. It's not good enough for a lot of people to keep paying you month after month for a long time. So if I personally bought this course from you, so maybe I take, you know, 1 or 2 months to fully go through it. Now, let's say you also offer ongoing weekly calls or monthly group coaching calls to help me and your other members. So after I've gone through it, I've tried and maybe implemented a few ads. I've asked you questions on a group call. I've gotten my answers. Maybe Facebook advertising works great for me. Maybe it doesn't work so great. And it's not the fault of your course, obviously, because remember, the implementation and execution of what I learned from you matters a whole lot more than just the information that I actually learned. Anyway, so let's say I keep a couple of Facebook campaigns going. Now, after a couple of months, 2 or 3 months, now think about it from my angle. Why should I keep paying you a subscription fee month after month if all I'm getting is this Facebook online video course? Obviously, you have the group coaching calls, and maybe you also have a forum in there with other members who have been going through your course. Probably most of them beginners and probably asking the same kind of questions as me. Maybe, you know, a few exceptions. Of a few students who are always the overachievers, right? But they won't have the time to help all the other members. They may not be the most vocal members. So I may very well feel that I've gotten all the value that I need to get from your course. I've learned your stuff, most of it. I've implemented some stuff. You coached me for a bit. I made some contacts through your Facebook group. Great. But why would I pay $20 or $50 or $100 a month after month going forward, just for this course and maybe the group, right? Even the group may not add value to me. So I probably don't need to be a member because I've extracted all the value I can get from your course, your group coaching, and your community. Now I know what you're thinking. But Ravi, that's why I've got this amazing course on Twitter advertising coming up. Then I'm going to follow that up with a course on Instagram advertising and then Pinterest advertising. Guess what? Most people may not care about those other courses because they don't care about, they can't handle so many social media platforms at the same time. So it was probably stressful enough to figure out everything for Facebook for me. I would rather dig down deep into Facebook advertising itself. I keep testing and tweaking my copy, my landing page, my headlines, my images, my videos, my custom audiences, and so on. Because I know it's not Facebook's fault that my campaigns didn't work. It was my execution and all the little things that I didn't take care of. So if I have extra cash each month, even if it's like $50 a month, I would rather think about it from a small business owner's perspective, right? I would rather put that into Facebook, back into Facebook ads, so I can get more out of my campaigns. I can pixel more people with the retargeting pixel and figure out which custom audience works by testing a lot of different types of audiences. Now, all of that takes a lot of time. And I would rather spend all my extra time going deep into Facebook rather than learn something about another new ecosystem, which I have to figure out, you know, another new set of ad interfaces and rules and strategies and tricks and tips and all this stuff for a whole new system. So your course about advertising on Twitter or Pinterest just does not excite me and probably won't excite others, most others. Now, of course, if you are running an online ad university of sorts, right, where your goal is to create ad experts in multiple platforms, then in that case, your audience actually just changed from training small business owners like me and website owners who don't want to outsource their advertising and who want to do their own advertising themselves. The audience just changed from those people to ad agencies and traffic and funnel experts who want to get paid to do the advertising for you and to drive traffic to their clients' websites. So that's a whole nother ball game. So that needs a completely different mindset. That's not what we're talking about here. So let's just stick to Facebook advertising course for normal small business owners and independent website owners. So a better way to get more money from me might be to offer a done-with-you service or a done-for-you service. In the done-with-you service, you can offer to do personal one-on-one calls where you go through my ad campaigns, for example. You can look at my copy, my landing page. You can offer fixes and tweaks and suggestions. And in the done-for-you service, you offer to do all that for me. And I would pay you a monthly fee for you to handle all of my Facebook ad campaigns. So going deeper into what your original course is about is a better upsell and a better way to go from a one-time product into a recurring subscription. Go deep, then wide. By the way, that is one of the chapter titles of a book I have planned for later this year or maybe even next year. Go deep, then wide. It's all about going vertical and doing a deep dive or going upwards and stacking on top of your existing products before branching out sideways and spreading yourself thin. Anyway, whether you go deep first or wide first also depends on the niche or niche. If you're in the body and fitness niche, for example, then yes, it makes sense to start with a course about, say you start with the losing belly fat, and then you can upsell me into a course that goes through training for my back and shoulders and upper body, lower body, mental health, diet, and so on, right? That's going wide. So not all your products and niches lend themselves easily to a recurring subscription model. So you're going to have to test your offers, right? You're going to have to tweak the landing page and sales copy and headlines and be creative with how you're packaging it. Going back to the Facebook course, even if you offer ongoing group calls and you have a community of members, I still may or may not be interested in continuing as a monthly subscriber because maybe I've already gotten the value I need to from your Facebook course, which means now you're back to the hamster wheel, trying to figure out new and creative ways to constantly keep adding new content, adding new courses, and coming up with new strategies just to keep your members coming back. Which is why in this case and many other cases, you are better off selling a one-time product for a slightly higher price, getting all the money upfront and not having to worry about people quitting after 3 months because they've already gotten enough value or people canceling because they never even bothered to view a single video, which happens a lot, more than you think, never bothered to take action, did nothing with it. And then one day they suddenly woke up and realized that they have this subscription going on. They're like, okay, let me not waste money. Let me come back later and when I'm ready for this. And they probably never come back. So I would suspect that for anyone that has pretty good content, most people are going to quit your membership site for two main reasons. They didn't get enough value because they probably didn't do anything with it. Again, not your fault. Or they already got enough value for what they paid for. So it's never really about the actual dollar amount or even about just the community. People will actually cancel a $5 a month subscription if it feels like a waste to them. And people will actually keep a $500 a month subscription if it provides enough value. So it's all about the value all the time. So it's not about just the content. It's not just about the community. And even if you have the greatest, most active community that has great discussions all the time and quickly responds with great answers to something that I don't need or care about anymore, it's just not worth for me to pay a monthly subscription if I'm not getting the value that I think I should be getting from it. Membership subscription pricing mistake number two. Offering a payment plan is not the same as creating a recurring subscription. So let me repeat that. A payment plan is not the same as a subscription. So don't simply take a one-time fee and split it into 12 months and think that now it's a membership site with a recurring fee and you're doing great. No. What you really did was just to offer them an extended payment plan which most people are guaranteed not to complete. And payment plans are not also great for smaller ticket items like a course that costs, you know, $47 or $97. Because depending on how important your topic is to your subscribers, and depending on how great your content and your community and coaching is, the average stick rate might be, say, only about 3 to 4 months. So let's say you have a course that sells for $99 and you don't have any other products created just yet. So now you might be tempted to create a subscription-based product on just that course alone, charging them, say, $9 a month. So if they paid monthly, they would end up paying $9 times 12, which is $108 over a year. But if they chose the yearly subscription, now they would pay only $99. So that's about $9 in savings, right? Now, if you change that $9 a month to $9.99, then the monthly fee accumulated over a year would still be only $119 and change. And compare that to $99 as a one-time payment. So now it becomes a slightly bigger savings of $20. But for the sake of argument and just easier to say $9, let's just go with the $9 a month subscription. So if you force them to choose between paying $99 a year or joining right now and get the same value for just $9 a month, they're almost always going to take the $9 a month subscription because they're probably thinking, I don't know if there's enough value in here for $99, so let me join at the lowest tier. And if I like it and find value, then maybe later I'll upgrade. So you kind of force them to go for the cheaper product. Now that's great as you become a more advanced seller, because now they can sample your whole thing for just $9, right? You can even offer a free trial when you become really confident with your content and with your with all the other aspects of your membership. And when you know that all you got to do is get them to sample and come in once and just participate for even 2 weeks, you can even give them a free trial or a $1 trial for 2 weeks. That's a different, whole other subject we're talking about in the beginning, right? So you kind of force your buyer, your member, to go for a cheaper $9 product for two reasons. Now, the overall savings over a year is not big enough to put a dent in their credit card account. It's only $9, or at worst, in the example I talked about, it's $119 versus $99, which is just $20. So it's not like they'll lose hundreds of dollars by not subscribing. They're only going to overpay by just $9 by selecting the monthly option. And even that, only if they end up staying for the whole year, right? Or if they cancel after 3 months, they only pay $27. So they won't lose $9 or overpay by $9 unless they stayed for a whole year. So the main thing here is that your subscription product at this point is not valuable enough, at least not yet, for them to consider paying a yearly subscription. So not only are they thinking about the bigger chunk that they have to pay now for your yearly subscription, but they also know that this is an ongoing thing that you're going to keep charging them every year. What if they don't want to come back next year? What if they forget to cancel? What if they realize that you know they forgot to cancel only after they see the next year's payment go through and their credit card bill comes and they're like, I've not been using it. How easy is it to contact you and will you even give them a refund? So they've probably got all these questions twirling around in their head. Now, that's what the sales page is for. You can do a lot to address all of these things in your sales copy or in your sales video. But guess what? Not everybody is going to read your entire sales page. In fact, most people won't. Most people will just skim through the page. They won't read the fine print. They'll just, you know, go from headline to headline and then they'll scroll all the way down and see what's the price, right? That's, and then they'll come back. If it's reasonable, then they'll come back and skim through it some more. So now they take you up on the $9 a month offer. And even if they stay for 3 months, because, you know, if it's an online course, like I mentioned in my Facebook ad course example earlier, there may not be a need to stay beyond a few months. So now they cancel after 3 months, which means you got $27 instead of the $120 they would have paid if that stayed a whole year. And it's not even the $99 that they would have paid if they had just subscribed yearly. So, and it, like I said, it's not easy to convince somebody to pay $99 year after year if your overall value is not up to snuff. So in this case, you're actually better off charging a one-time fee of $99, which means instead of $27, you're now making at least $99. And because it's now a one-time payment and not a recurring monthly payment, you'll have fewer billing issues like credit cards not working because they changed their bank or they are over their credit limit, or they moved and they didn't update the billing address in PayPal or in your membership system and so on. PayPal sometimes shuts people's accounts down because they did a flurry of refunds or did a huge launch and then it rapidly took out all the money, or they don't even have enough PayPal balance. And there's so many reasons, right? In our business, we have thousands of DAP users, and I can't even begin to tell you how many payments fail every day. Now, of course, DAP, or digitalaccesspass.com, makes it easy for you to manage those failed payments. But still, if they keep failing and failing, then Authorize.net or PayPal or Stripe will cancel their subscription after a few tries, which means you now have to contact the member and ask them to sign up using a new credit card or update their PayPal account with a different credit card. And they may actually just simply ignore your emails because they don't really want to come back for whatever reason, right? Which means now you're back to the hamster wheel, wondering what you can do to make your content and your community and your coaching so compelling that they can't afford to have their account terminated. You could raise the monthly subscription fee, but not the yearly, so that the difference between paying monthly and paying yearly is substantial. So let's say you now, instead of $9 a month, you charge them $20 a month and only $100 if paid yearly. So that's a difference of $240 versus $100, which is $140. That's a pretty big difference. But now the question arises, if your content is basically a single course and some, you know, casual things added on top of it, like community, which you won't be able to build quickly because, you know, everybody's on Facebook. It's really hard to motivate a community, but we'll go into that in a different podcast episode. So even if your thing is just a single course, are you able to position it in such a way to charge $240 for it, at least on paper, assuming that they do take up the monthly option? If not, you're making them think that right from the beginning that I'll just stay for a couple of months and cancel because they don't want to pay $240 for something that doesn't have that kind of value. So everything depends on how you package the subscription. But guess what? In the beginning, you don't have much to package into the subscription. You don't have the skills of copywriting or positioning or price anchoring and all the stuff that comes with internet marketing. You don't have all those high-level skills, advanced skills, to convince somebody to pay month after month after month that too for a slightly higher priced, like $20 or $30 or $50 a month subscription. So I use round numbers in this example because it's kind of easy to do the math. Normally, I would recommend a number ending in 9 or sometimes even 7. Like 27, 47, 97, or 29, 49, 99, etc. So if your monthly fee is $19 a month, make it $199 a year. The trick is to simply 10x the monthly price, right? So 19 a month, $199 a year. 29 a month, $299 a year. 49 a month, $499 a year. You get the idea. So in every case, you'll see that the yearly subscription actually gives your members a 20% discount because it gives them 2 months off. And that is the equivalent of only paying 10 months a year. So all these problems with credit cards, members canceling, not enough incentive to come back, all of those are not a problem when you have a SaaS product, software as a service product like DAP. Now, even though DAP is a self-hosted WordPress plugin, we do have one membership tier where you pay a nominal fee for it monthly. And in return, you get like DAP and all of our plugins, like I said before, concierge calls and so on. So we did have to package quite a bit, whole bunch of benefits in order to be able to charge a subscription fee for DAP, which is a membership plugin, like a SaaS product. So in our case, if their monthly payment fails, they'll usually quickly update their credit card or PayPal account with a new credit card because they don't want their DAP license to be terminated, because then their software on the DAP admin section on their website will not work. But again, this is because it's software, and that too, not just any WordPress plugin, right? Because this is your membership plugin that forms the core of your business. That's like the operating system of your computer, operating system of your business. So like web hosting or your merchant account or your office rent. You don't want to mess with those things and risk losing the service just because you forgot to update your billing address after you move. So people in this case will quickly update their payment information and get the subscription back on track. So SaaS services are a totally different ballgame than just regular online courses and membership sites. So that means here's the main question you have to ask yourself. If Joe's subscriber's credit card fails and fails multiple times, and you also send multiple reminders and they just keep ignoring it, can they eventually afford to lose access to the product or service you're offering as part of your membership site? if it happens with a SaaS product like DAP, like I said, they can't afford to lose their access to the software. But what if this happens with an online course? Can your members afford to lose access for a month or two? What about if their subscription completely gets canceled due to credit card issues? What if they never come back? Can they afford not to come back? Can they afford to even take a few months off? So you have to think about all that and answer it truthfully for yourself and do everything to increase the value of what you're providing and make your membership site more sticky, which I'll talk about in a future episode. But for the most part, at least in the beginning, with a couple of products that you launch, it just makes sense to get paid a one-time fee all upfront. So you may still have, you should still, for the sake of price anchoring and positioning and making your one-time product look good, you should have a recurring subscription tier on your website. It's just that the subscription product is a decoy. And all you're really doing is pushing people towards the one-time product in the beginning. And then later, the one-time product can become a decoy and you're pushing people towards your subscription product. So don't feel pressured into starting a membership site as your first product launch.
Subscribe.fm.
I sincerely believe that that's the biggest difference between this show and a few other shows that talk about membership sites and online courses. A lot of the other shows will give you regurgitated content that you could probably get with a quick Google search. I don't give you just bullet points and tell you what you should do. Like, here's 20 ways to do blah. It's not a list post. It's not narrating a list post. My style is more like, here are the three best ways or two best ways or five best ways to do this, because I have tried these things, because here's what has worked for me. Here's what has not worked for me. Here's how I've seen it working for my clients. And that's why you should do it this way. Okay, so remember that special announcement I talked about towards the beginning of the show? Here it is. If you currently have an online or offline business and you wish to grow your business to the next level, whether you're making $1,000 or $10,000 or even $1 million, and you want to get to the next level and you can use help getting to that next level in your business, then I can help. I have just launched the world's most unique coaching program where I offer you the craziest guarantee you have ever heard. Ready for this? Once you sign up for my coaching program, whatever coaching fees you pay me, I guarantee you that you'll make it all back within a year, maybe even within a few months. Again, that's depending on where you are with your current business and where you, what your goals are and so on. But we can talk about that. So basically, the guarantee is if you don't make it all back, whatever you pay me within a year, if I don't help you make that back as additional extra income in your business over and above what you're already making currently, then I will give you your full money back at the end of 365 days of coaching and consulting. So it doesn't matter if I spend 10 hours or 20 hours or 50 hours working with you. You get to keep all the benefits of my coaching you and whatever improvements you've made to your business and income and all during that time. You get to keep all that. So if I don't deliver, then my coaching, my time and knowledge, everything I gave you, it's all free for you and your business because you get a full refund. And if I do deliver, then you already made back the money that you spent on me for coaching, which is basically what my guarantee is. So either way, it becomes free for you. You win either way. Whether I deliver, don't deliver, my coaching, consulting, brainstorming, improving your business, your sales page, your funnels, everything, traffic source, helping you with podcasting or whatever, video creation, audio creation, everything. We'll go through end to end. Creating a long-term business plan. Everything becomes free for you either way. And if you actually execute the strategies and tactics and techniques and business plan that I create for you, that we work on together and agree upon and create together for you, and something that's, you know, obviously reasonable and executable and within what you can do within your limits as an individual and business, then there's no telling how much of a leap you can take in your business this next 12 months. And because it is such a crazy offer, you will have to apply for it first and give me some details about your current state of your business. And because I don't know how this experiment is going to work out, I'm going to give you this guarantee only if you're one of the next 10 people to sign up for my coaching program. So even if you're slightly interested, just go ahead and send me an email right after you finish listening to this episode to ravi@subscribeme.fm. That's ravi@subscribeme.fm. Or if you can't remember that, just go to my website, subscribeme.fm, and send me an email to the contact form there. You can support this podcast by subscribing to it. Just search for Subscribe Me, all one word, in your favorite podcast app. Or if you're on an Apple device, just go to subscribeme.fm/iTunes. And if you're on an Android device, go to subscribeme.fm/Android. And to listen on the web, just go to subscribeme.fm. And you can listen to all of the episodes from this show right from the homepage without even having to scroll down. And all the links I mentioned in this episode will be available in the show notes at subscribeme.fm/61. So yeah, everything I've talked about on the show, I will be talking about in the future. Everything comes from selling online and marketing online, creating digital products and services and software, developing products, being creative, making mistakes since 1997. So that's when I started my first website. Here I am 21 years later, and there's still so much to learn, so much to achieve, so much to give. And to quote Robert Frost, I have promises to keep and miles to go before I sleep. Super thrilled to have you come along for the ride and letting me share what little I know with you. Hope you liked it. Until the next time, thank you so much for listening. I really, really appreciate you letting me into your personal space and for listening to my show. Cheers and talk soon.